In the first video of our Bitcoin series, we touched on cryptocurrency mining. In this video, we're going to delve deeper into how it works. Digital currencies don't use central ledger systems like banks do. This means coins can go straight from one person to another without needing to be processed by a central ledger first, which not only makes transaction times faster, but also does not incur the administration costs involved with a traditional ledger system, making it cheaper for both the sellers and buyers to use. How this works is every transaction requires a very complex algorithm to be solved to figure out in what order should transactions go in, i.e. should Frank's transaction to Bill go first or should Fred's? These algorithms also make sure coins are going to the right person at the right amount and the same coin isn't being spent more than once. This is where miners come into play. Each time one of these algorithms is solved, a predetermined amount of coins depending on the currency being mined are released and given to the miners for the services they provided. This is also an incentive for more people to mine. A consequence of more people mining the currency is that it becomes available to scale, as it can now handle the increased amount of transactions from users. Depending on how quickly the problems are being solved, the algorithms will change their difficulty to maintain a constant rate of new coins entering the market. Originally, miners used fast processors in their computers to solve these equations. However, early on, these miners realized that graphics cards used for gaming were much more effective and faster for solving these algorithms. However, these graphics cards used a lot of electricity and became very hot, causing them to be damaged. The next evolution in mining was the dedicated digital currency mining products that had chips in them specifically created for mining to be much faster at solving algorithms and use less electricity to increase profits and reduce overheating. However, over time, these technologies have only become better and better. And in this series, we will be looking at them individually and potentially purchasing one in the future to test them out. Due to the large number of miners and the rising difficulty of the algorithms, it is extremely difficult for any one computer to solve these problems on their own. This resulted in miners coming together as a group to combine the power of their individual machines to essentially create one big mining computer, and the earnings are rewarded to the individual miners depending on how much work their individual computer did. This technique is called pooling, which is a technique used by 99.9% of miners and what you will most likely use with any software to mine any digital currency. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to share it with your friends. Remember, sharing is caring. We're going to keep looking into digital currencies as a way to create a passive income stream, so be sure to stay up to date by subscribing. Thanks.